In today's video, I'm going to show you how to install the PlayStation 2 emulator called NetherSX2 without using a Windows PC as it is usually shown. We will do everything from our Android device. If you want me to bring you more emulators of different consoles, leave it in the comments. The first thing will be to go to the official NetherSX2 GitHub repository. There we will have all the necessary steps explained in the section for Android, so we will only have to follow the instructions that are indicated. The first step is to install the UniPatcher application with which we can modify the APK that we will see below. Once the application is installed, we download the APK file by clicking on the link. Then we will go to the releases section and we will take the latest available version of the file with X-Delta extension. With this, we will have completed the requirements, having all the necessary files to start the installation process. We go down to the Android installation section and follow the steps as described. We start by opening the UniPatcher application and selecting the file with extension X-Delta in the first section called Patch File. Now in ROM file, we select the APK file that we downloaded earlier. Finally, we select a name for the resultant file and click on the red button to start the patching process that will take very little time. Once it has finished, we can install it looking for it in our file explorer and installing it like any other APK. When it has been installed, we open the application and follow the steps that appear on the screen. First, we have to choose the directory where we have the PS2 ROMs. In my case, I have them on the external microSD card as they occupy enough. We will have to give permissions to the emulator to access this directory. After this, the games will be imported. Before being able to start any game, it is necessary to go to the emulator settings and import a BIOS. I can't share these files because it would be piracy, but once you have them, you only have to click on Import BIOS and choose the one you have. Now we can start any game, for example Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi 3. I also recommend you to change the touch controls to dual analog pad mode, so that you have all the controls available on screen. If you use Bluetooth controllers, you can also map them automatically to the emulator from the automatic mapping option in the controller section. As a curiosity, you can connect several controllers and play in local multiplayer mode with your friends. I leave you a small test of how the emulator works by default. The truth is that everything goes quite well, but the performance can be improved, and we can increase the resolution at which the games are executed with respect to their original PS2 resolution. You can also launch the games from some front-end emulators like Digishow. If you want a video where I design how to install and configure it, leave it in the comments. The truth is very cool and gives the feeling of having a console in our Android. Regarding the graphical theme, some options that I recommend changing are the ones I show you below. If we go to the settings section, we can activate the option to see the FPS. In the graphics section, I recommend you to change the GPU renderer to Vulkan and the native resolution to the one supported by your device. For example, I have left it at 3x the original resolution, and as you can see in the upper right part, the FPS are quite low, so I will have to lower it to 2x the native resolution or a little less. I hope you also like this kind of videos, not so much of Android and Linux. If you want me to bring you how to turn your Android device into a gaming console, leave it in the comments.